So what's the crime of obstructing governmental operations in Alabama? We defense lawyers think of this as a popo crime, meaning pissed off police officer. It is a crime that is very often charged when the police are just that. They're annoyed, they're looking for something to throw on somebody, and this is a common charge. Which is not to say that it's not always a legitimate charge. Many times it is, but it's also often used as a tool when the police are angry at a citizen and the encounter isn't going the way the cops want it. They want to put something on the person. So let's talk about what it is. There's two ways the crime can be committed. Let's talk about the first. One way is that a person commits the crime of obstructing governmental operations if by means of intimidation, physical force or interference, or some other independently unlawful act, they intentionally obstruct or impair or hinder the administration of law or some other governmental function. Let's say that our friend Martha McGee, who lives at 221 Slap Out Road, gets tipped off that they're coming there, the police are coming to serve a lawful search warrant on her house. Well, she doesn't want them to do this, so what does she do? She goes and pulls the 221 sign off the side of her house, goes down the street, goes grabs her neighbor's sign that says 220, pulls his off, puts her 221 up there, takes the 220 and puts 220 on her house. Police roll up. Unfortunately for Martha, they're familiar with her, they're familiar with the house, they're not fooled. Martha has committed the crime of obstructing governmental operations because she was trying to obstruct or impair them from doing their lawful governmental function of executing the search warrant. So that's when somebody does something to impair the governmental operation. The other way the crime is committed is when somebody intentionally prevents a public servant from performing a governmental function. So they're really one and the same thing. It's just that the second way is the focus is on the actual governmental servant. So let's say that Martha gets out and her son has been arrested and the cops are now coming because he's made bond, he's out, and she's heard he's violated bond. Cops are coming and they are coming to serve a new warrant on him. Cop comes, he shows up, he's got a warrant in hand. And Martha walks over, Marlboro hanging out of her mouth, and she goes, "You ain't serving that on my son." That would be obstructing governmental operations because she's trying to prevent the officer from serving the warrant. So that's obstructing governmental operations. If you or somebody you love is accused of this crime, whether legitimately or not legitimately, you need a lawyer. It carries up to a year in jail, so it can be a pretty serious offense. It's a Class A misdemeanor. If you're here in North Alabama and you'd like our help, just give us a call. Our phone number is listed below. We're happy to help. I hope you found this video to be educational and informative. Thank you very much for watching. And if you want to see more of these, please subscribe. I try to put one out every Friday if I can. Thanks for watching.